Unfortunately, there's no Redshift release for Houdini 20.5 yet. I'll show you how to use it anyway, and fix the color management issue with a system variable that also sets up Blender, 3ds Max, and Maya. We'll start by visiting the Redshift forum website, redshift.maxon.net. Log in with your Maxon account, go to the user section, and search for Juanjo Gonzalez. Click on his name, and you'll find the Redshift version for Houdini you're looking for at the bottom left. Click on the Windows link, and you'll see two zip files available for download in the top right corner. Of course, you need to sign in to Dropbox first. Once downloaded, unzip the main file, and then unzip the two files contained within. You should now have two folders, one for Houdini and one for Solaris. Next, navigate to the Redshift plugin directory on your computer by going to C, Program Data, Redshift and Plugins. You'll find two folders here as well, one for Houdini and one for Solaris. Open the Houdini folder from the downloaded plugin. Inside this Houdini folder, you'll find the current plugin for Houdini 20.5. Now, open the Houdini folder under your current installation. Here you can see the previous Redshift plugins for Houdini. We'll copy the 20.5 folder into this directory. Next, go back one step and open the Solaris folder from the downloaded plugin. In this folder, you'll find the plugin for Solaris. On our hard drive, navigate to the Solaris folder under Plugins. Here you'll see the older versions as well. Logically, we'll drag the new Solaris version into our Plugins folder here as well. Now, we need to tell Houdini where to find these files. We do this by creating a file where we specify the locations of the plugin for Houdini and Solaris. On the desktop, right-click to create a new text file and open it. Copy the provided text from the documentation and paste it into this file. That might seem daunting, but it's actually not that hard to understand. The Redshift root variable defines the base directory for the Redshift plugin. The Houdini path variable is generated by combining the Redshift root variable with a specific folder and the version of Houdini that has been launched. The PXR plugin path name variable performs the same function, but specifically for Solaris. The path variable precisely defines where Houdini finds the necessary Redshift commands. Just make sure that Redshift is correctly installed in this location. Otherwise, you'll need to manually adjust the Redshift path. Save and close the file. Rename the file to redshift.json. Then copy the file into the Houdini directory. By default, you'll find Houdini under Program Files and then Side Effects Software. Open the 20.5 folder. Next, go to the Packages folder. In this folder, you'll find more JSON files that Houdini automatically loads when it starts. Now copy the redshift.json file into this folder. Launch Houdini. And you should now see Redshift in the menu. However, if you encounter an error that says failed aborting render, we need to install the OCIO color management. To do this, visit opencolorio.org. In the menu, go to Documentation, then select Quick Start for Artists. Scroll down to Downloads and choose OCIO version 2 ACES configurations. Now click on OpenColorIO version 2.3.0. At the very bottom, you'll find the zip file labeled source code. I will extract everything to my C drive. Now, we need to tell Houdini where I've saved everything. When I use software that relies on OCIO color management, I have to set it up for each individual program. To make things easier in the future, we'll set an environment variable in Windows for OCIO. This way, everything will work seamlessly across different programs like Blender, Maya, or 3ds Max. These programs directly access the corresponding system variable. Let's set up this system variable now. Press the Start key on your keyboard, type ENV for environment, and click on Edit the System Environment Variables. Now, select the Environment Variables button. Click New under System Variables. For the variable name, enter OCIO. For the variable value, navigate to the OpenColorIO2 3.0 folder. Then go to Source or SRC. Next, go to OpenColorIO, open the built-in configs folder. Finally, go to the configs folder. Here you'll see the configuration files that contain all the settings. Copy the full path of this folder to your clipboard. Paste the path as the value of the environment variable. Next, copy the name of the configuration file. Choose the file named version 1, 0.0 ACES, version 1.3 OCIO version 2.1. Add a slash at the end, followed by the complete file name. confirm everything, and restart Houdini. When you open Redshift now, it should work smoothly. Go to the render view, set display to Rec 709, and under view, choose Asus 1.0 SDR video. We can now use Redshift for Houdini 20.5. To wrap things up, let's take a quick look at Blender. I'll head over to the render properties and then to color management. Here you can now see the Asus color management system. If I remove the OCIO Windows system environment variable and reopen Blender, we'll have the standard color management instead. All right, that's it for this video. If you found this video helpful or enjoyable, give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to the channel. Have a great day and see you in the next video.